What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? It's me, Mikey Pipes. Thank you so much for tuning in. I hope I'll be able to entertain and also educate. Because together, by learning something new every day, we can make the trades great again. And that's my goal. I want to make the trades great again. I want to leave a legacy to the future generations. I want to make moves. And one of the moves that I'm making, and one of the moves that I decided to make once the Mikey Pipes Pipe Doctor YouTube channel hit 100,000 subscribers, was that I decided we're going to give back. And 2% of all gross revenue from Pipe Doctor is being funneled to a 503c charity that I set up called Mikey Pipes Philanthropy, where we are going to, and we're going to move mountains. We are going to provide, at no cost, plumbing and heating services to those in need who genuinely can't afford it. Because it is, I really believe, and I know all of you believe, that it is a basic human right to have functional plumbing in your home, and also have a safe and functional heating system. So in a couple days from now, we're actually doing our first service call for a gentleman in Queens. Told me a really, really heartbreaking story. But check it out, the channel, Mikey Pipes Philanthropy. A bunch of you have already subscribed, even though there's really nothing there yet. But on Friday, me and Peter, we're going to do our first pro bono philanthropy cause. And let me tell you something about the Mikey Pipes Philanthropy YouTube channel. 100% of all ad revenue, right? All sponsorships, everything, anything that that channel brings in, we're going to utilize to get things done for people in need. And why I set up the 50507C, whatever it's called, charity, the IRS charities, because it's a legitimate organization. You know, I want distributors, manufacturers, wholesalers, you know, every Tom, Dick, and Harry, I want them to also donate, even if it's a dollar, right? Together, we're going to make the trades great again. And this Friday, we're doing our first service call. So stick around and make sure you subscribe to the YouTube channel, Mikey Pipes Philanthropy. All right, in the meantime, we're heading right now to a service call in St. Albans, Queens. A gentleman's got a slant fin boiler, and he needs something about a relay. So that's all I know, and we'll figure it out, all right? In the meantime, smash that thumbs up button, and please check out Mikey Pipes Philanthropy website. We're going to make moves together, and together we're going to make the trades great again and give back to the community one at a time. Let's go.
All right, the slant fin gas-fired boiler. Basement zone, first floor, second floor, two-family house. This relay right here controls heat on the first and the second floor because they're wired in together. We're going to install the Taco SR503 three-zone switching relay. We're going to put it right here where these two zone relays are, and giving the homeowner the opportunity to split the first floor and second floor once a thermostat is installed. Now, if we put in a Honeywell 8000 on this wall right here and put in the wireless remote sensor, we don't got to run a wire, because now the thermostat's here, the remote sensor's in the second floor apartment, and the homeowner gets to give consistent temperature to the occupied space, which is the second floor. Let's get it.
All right, removed TT and XX. TT is from thermostat, which is two wire connection. You see right there. XX is to turn on and switch on boiler. Now we're going to take off power and power to circulate.
All right, since this relay was not controlling boiler, it was controlling Aquastat, we can now get rid of the strap on Aquastat,
because now the relay is going to communicate with the boiler, and the set point on the Aquastat will control boiler turn on and shut off. So the only thing we need to do is get rid of this T connection right here, because we're not using the strap on Aquastat anymore. And next we can get rid of this box and then work on the next.
All right, blank canvas. I did move the relief valve out a little bit because it was smack up against the left relay box. So now that that's out of the way, this will go right there.
easy peasy. And we are, have a power switch here. Ooh, George Pierce. Old school electrical contractor. This is the power switch for the boiler. This is the power switch for, we're gonna make circulators. So this will still have two purposes. One is the power relay, which is gonna then power the circulators. And then the other switch is going to power the boiler. So we have independent shutoff. Not typically seen, but we have two switches. Might as well take advantage of it. All right, switching relay is mounted. It's level. I could have just used the jacket, boiler jacket, to prove it's level. But the boiler's not sitting on the floor level. Didn't look like it, but... not that it makes a difference, but I'm a perfectionist. Okay, let's take a look at our SR503 three-zone switching board. We have zone three priority. We're going to turn that off. It's the first thing we're going to do. We don't have an indirect water heater. If you had an indirect water heater, you hook it up to zone three, and hot water will always take priority. Isolated end switch, XX. This is going to go to TT on that Honeywell Aquastat relay right there. All right. We're going to bring 110 volts in. To the left-hand side of the high voltage bus, right there. Sorry, right-hand side. Wah, wah, wah. And then zones 1, 2, and 3. 1, 2, 3. I guess I can make the boiler the first ground floor, zone 1. Yeah, let's do that. 1, 2, basement third zone. Easy peasy. All right, so I took basement zone. We made that zone 3, which is right there. It says priority, but priority is off. We're not going to use that. And I cut down the Romex, sorry, the BX. This is armored sheathed cable. And back in the days, this was invented for New York City code so the rats wouldn't eat through the wiring. That's what they did back in the days. They also have armor sheathed thermostat cable, thermostat wire, which is very hard to cut through. Now, you can use a BX cutter. Also referred to as MC cutter, an MC cable cutter, but I like to use my angle grinder and carefully cut on a little bit of an angle, hence the angle grinder, and then pop in my BX connector. So there's basement zone to zone 3. I have two more to go. It looks like I'll be able to disconnect this from here and put that right there, and then zone 1 I'll be able to take out of here and bring that there. Or I may just get rid of it in its entirety, but yeah, I should get it out of here because, yeah, we don't need it there. We don't need it coming out of that electric box. All right, let's take a look inside of our electric box that has the two switches. We have a bunch of thermostat wiring in here, which is a no-no. By the way, you don't mix line voltage and low voltage in the same box, but back in the days, they didn't care. All right, so we know that, wow, look at this. This brown wire, which is with this, did nothing. Absolutely nothing. See that? So let's just not connect anything. Look. So let's get rid of that. Okay. Now, we have this brown wire, which I'm almost positive is going to be our first floor thermostat. All right. So this brown wire, oh, look at this, a little spill switch, which probably was there at one point. Look at that. See? Spill switch. Okay. And black is obviously our incoming power, line voltage. The white is neutral. All the neutrals get tied together, as you see. And this brown, we'll just take it out of the box. We're going to take this brown wire with the blue and the white, and we'll bring that right outside the box where it should be. And then we'll be good. All right, let's take a closer look at the electric panel. This 1900 box, we have a line going to this left switch, single pole, single throw switch. Then it piggybacks to the other switch, leaving this left switch, feeding the boiler, and leaving this switch. We're feeding the input on the three zone relay. And where does this go? And here. All right.
So this right here, right, which is off of there, we don't need anymore. As a matter of fact, we don't even need this little pigtail here anymore because we're going to bring this wire, which is going feeding that three-zone relay, right, to the switch. So switch on the left will be boiler, switch on the right will be relay. All right. So our neutrals are all three of them, now that one's removed, are all connected to that Wago. That's the lever connector, glorified wire nut. It's the three-conductor version, model 221. The glorified wire nut, I love them, they're epic. My switch on the right controls the relay, which is all the circulators. And here is my thermostat from first floor. Let's put this back together and secure it back and turn the power. Okay, end switch is wired to TT right there on the Aquastat relay. Zone one and zone two share the same five conductor wire. Red and white is zone one. Yellow and blue is zone two, which goes right here. I took that brown wire that goes to the first floor thermostat, which is identified as blue and white, which is R, H, and W. And I used three conductor Wago wire connector for temporarily zone thermostat on the first floor will turn on both zones. Okay. Boiler switch. Okay. Basement zone. Basement zone activates that switch right there. And if I were to jump out, let's say zone three, hope it doesn't blow up on me. See, zone three is energized. The boiler has a spark ignition and has main ignition. All right, let's jump out zone one. Zone two and three, sorry, zone one and two are illuminated. The relay, which is right here, is a 24 volt Aquastat relay. So here is our Aquastat connection. Right back here is a probe or a well inside the boiler that senses the boiler temperature. This is the transformer, and we have 24 volt burner circuit and 110 volt circulator circuit. So when there's a call on TT there, all right, it's not gonna do it there because I need to do it here. See? Like that. All right, there's power to that. Okay. And zone three, which is down there, is powered and the boiler is running. Now we're gonna try, let that heat up, and then we'll do zone one and two. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. We took out two single zone switching relays and we installed one three zone Taco SR503 three zone switching relay. And as soon as he runs a wire to the second floor apartment, we will have three separate individually controlled heating zones, and that will maximize the efficiency of the current system. Now, an observation, I could have added a single zone relay and left those two in place. That is correct. And I actually, when I first arrived and he told me what he wanted to do, I proposed adding one from my truck. However, he had the switching relay on hand, so I installed his goods. Did that change the price? Absolutely. It did not change the price for the trip charge or the hourly rate, but it actually changed the hourly rate, because the single zone relay I would have done within the hour, where the three zone relay I did within the hour and a half, and that took me about an hour and 40 minutes. And that's with recording, you know, here and there, snippets along the way. But the labor rate didn't change. The only thing that changed was I'm not supplying the good, and I'm also not warranting the job, you know, his parts. Because when a customer, a client gives me material or goods to install, there's no warranty on the job, including the workmanship. Now, I know it may seem like, oh, why don't you warranty your workmanship? Because my workmanship is good, and hence you saw it on video. And the part can go defective, and it could look like it's workmanship, but
nonetheless, anytime a client gives a professional, a guy in the trades for me, example, or you know, any other plumber that follows the same practices, we do not guarantee the job whatsoever. And it's written right on my invoice. But I could have installed a one zone relay. Instead, I installed his supply three zone relay. The pros to that is that I had space. I could have added a single zone relay there. There was room there. But the pros to adding the single zone, individual. So if one relay dies completely, at least the two other zones work. Now, in this case, there are onboard fuses on the Taco switching relay. So if the fuse, if there's a problem and the fuse burns out, the circulator burns out, you know, that doesn't kill the whole thing unless the transformer dies, for example. But yeah, that's it, guys. So any questions about how I wired that, feel free to email me, mike@mikeypipes.com, and I'll be more than glad to respond to your inquiry on doing that. If you have any questions, you want to chat about that, check us out on the WhatsApp group chat, where there's about 250 of us quite active on it. All right, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Until next time, be well, God bless, stay safe, and make sure you check out the Mikey Pipes Philanthropy website, the channel, and subscribe, because this Friday coming up, we're just a couple days away, we're doing our first service call where we're giving back to the community. It's going to be epic, and we're going to make moves together. We're going to make the trades great again together. Thank you. Be well. God bless.